Hi friends, good morning to everyone. This video is fully beginners for AgiSoft Metashape. In this video I am going to create how to process the drone data image processing in AgiSoft Metashape, and also I am going to explore that how to process the OrthoMosaic and dem using with drone data, with ground control point. Let's start the process now. This is the AgiSoft Metashape software window. This is now I'll close this all. Yeah, after open the Metashape, if you go to title bar and right click, there you can get it, workspace, console, photos and reference pane. So here that main important things of workspace and reference pane. Yes, see, after clicking that, you can see here that workspace and reference pane here, the bottom left bottom, you can see the workspace and reference pane. Yeah, then after that we need photos. Once you click the photos, immediately you can see this, see the bottom part, the photos. You can reduce and enlarge this windows. Yes, okay, let's add the photos. There is one tool called workflow. Now you can add photos or add folder, the entire folder. Now I'm going to add the folder. Once click the add folder, select the directory where you have the photos. Yes, I have it there, photos in the demo videos. Yes, it's called around 42 cameras are there. When I click OK, the photos will be out. Yes, we successfully added the photos into the Metashape. Yeah, the next step, after adding the photos, you can see the camera images here, latitude, longitude and altitude. This is from the drone image exif data. Okay, if exif is not there, you cannot see the location of the camera. At the top of the taskbar, there are lot of tools are there. There show cameras are, one tool is there. If you switch off and switch on the cameras, and also you can rotate and see the cameras. Yes, if any cameras are up and down, that you can remove that. If you remove, then you will get the better output of the ortho. Okay, let's go for the process now. Yes, the first process called align photos. The align is, yeah, there are the accurate, there is lot of parameters are there in general and advanced. In general there is called accuracy, there is a lot of accuracy, lowest, low, medium, high and highest. This is little difference of in between of the accuracy, like if you process the lowest, the process will go speed, it will create the lowest accuracy of ortho. Yes, based on these parameters you will get the accuracy of output. Yes, now I'm going to create the ortho with medium accuracy. Yes, Another one is, there are another parameters called generic preselection and reference preselection. Generic preselection is if your data don't have the cameras don't have the TXIP data, then you can select the generic preselection. This will help to match the photos as much accuracy as much possible point. Okay. Another one called reference preselection. This will help to match the photos with the EXIP data. It will take the reference of this EXIP latitude longitude while aligning. Okay. Another one is called advanced preselection. That is called the key point and tie point limit. Here, key point will create the. It will use the. It will be useful for the matching the each camera position. Yes. This another one is called type points. Now here I am choosing the mention the type point is key point is 50,000 and type point limit is 10,000. Yes. Another one called that adaptive camera model fitting. Yes. Now I set up all the parameters for aligned photos. Let's start. Okay. Yes. This will take time. Once this process done, align process is done, you will see the workspace itself. You will see the sparse cloud point. Okay, let's finish the process now. Now the align process is done. Okay. So you can, after finishing this process, you can see the photos, the cameras are looks like this. All cameras are aligned. Simple this. Yes. All cameras are aligned. Now you can switch off the camera. You can see the good workspace and you can see the sparse cloud here. This is the sparse cloud. Okay, let's save the project first. Save. Yes, project. Photogrammetry. Demo videos. Okay, I keep outside of the demo videos. Demo. The project will create as a demo.psx. Next step is, if you have the GCP, then you can go to, if you have the any ground control point for this area, you can now, then you can go to reference span and there one book, there you can see the marker area. Here you can create the add markers. And you can rename it this called GCP 1. Same like this, you can create one more GCP 2, GCP 3. There is for processing minimum 3 GCP required. Maximum you can keep number of GCP, but minimum 3 GCP is must. Okay, I'll create now with 4 GCPs. Okay, 4 GCPs. Sorry. Okay, GCP 1 and GCP 2, GCP 4. So now we can find out where the GCPs are there. For example, I have the MORPEG here. This is called as GCP 1. Place one marker. Then once after placing the mortar, you can see the photos like this. The flock, you will see the white flock, blue flock and green block. Green block is this marker as projection. This is called the projection. That green color is you placed one projection for that camera. Okay. Blue color is a good position, a good camera for the placing the marker. The white color is not good for the placing the projection. So better to select the blue color cameras. So if we go there, we select the blue color, then you will get it here. You can automatically it will come there, and you can move it the right place. Yes. Go now. Here, one more method. After placing the two GCPs, two projections. Sorry, after placing the two projection, you can filter the photo spy markers. Then you will, once you click the camera, automatically it will be set there. Yes. See. Minimum 3 is enough, but better keep as much projection, at least 12, at least 10. Okay. Yes.
Okay, guys, check that how many green blocks are there. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Place another one, 10 green plugs are there. So it's that good for the projection. Second, in the process, so you can enable the plug show marker, and you will see the finished marker. The second GCP is to find out, I do that where the surveyor place GCP in this layer. So the second GCP is over there. I will filter, right click and filter by points. So that area of cameras everything will filter here. So go there. It is church here. See, I can see the one marker here. So right click, place marker GCP 2. Right. Other one is for filtering the markers, I need at least 2 projection is needed to mark. Okay. Like this, we need to find out that. reference span, filter photos by markers. The filter and give all the area. Once you double click the camera, so this is the blue cloth plug. That blue cloth plug is a good one for placement protection. So once double click, automatically it will go that location. Okay. Just keep moving the center part. Yes. Now I place to Diana projection for GCP 2. Yes. Now GCP 3. Check out. Yes. So I can place here this is the here. Yes. We do reference span, we do the same thing, filter photos by markers. Yes, it's filter and views, this is the place. But I don't want not much this projection for small area. Anyway, this is the small area, I can take 10 projections for enough. This view I think. Yes. Right. So we place 10 projections for the 3 GCPs. Yes. We can switch off and put on the flap. We can call we need another one more GCP better for better accuracy. See one more, okay, that is for GCP 4. I'll keep GCP 4 here. If I can report, here. So I chose this place, which I think is not good because of white flag. Don't want that. See, this is blue color flag, it looks like very clear. Yes, go to the 4 and filter photos by markers. Yes. See, the blue plus R looks very clear pixel in the camera. Yes. I have placed the enough number of projection. Yes. Yeah, so marking is over. After finishing the marker, you need to import the latitude and longitude with elevate altitude also. So first you need to figure out create the CSV file for this. Okay, I'm going to open the QGIS. See, I have the CSV file of the surveyor thing. Yes, I import the CSV file. This thing, nothing. Actually this area is big area, but I selected only a small part for the demo purpose. They are called around 7 markers are there, but for this small area I choose only the 4 markers. So I want to, now our thing is we need to place the import the markers reading here. So this is 6512. 6512. Only these 4 markers only our area covered. Okay. let's filter only these four markers 6, 5, 1, 2. Okay. 6, 5, 1, 2. Okay, let's go there. Rename the markers here 1, two. This is 5. So look at now the order is correct. This is 5, 2, 1, 6, 5, sorry, 6, 5, 1, 2. 6, this is 6. 5 is labels, this should be correct. Okay. 5. Minus 2. Okay. 5. GCP location labels are corrected. Okay. The next step is import the marker here. Go to reference pan, that tool called import. Go to select your CSV file. Yes. Select the AgiSoft comma separation. I call name missing, not in and name missing. Not to all, because of I don't want to place all markers, I want to place only the four markers. Yes. See, look at I place. The next step is called optimization. What the optimizers will do that process will correct the point from the exit value to your GCP reading value. So I move to the reference pan, select all the cameras and right click and uncheck all the cameras. Okay, then move to optimize cameras, select all all the general options. We have all the options called the camera levels and along with advanced fit, along with this select the advanced camera model fitting also. Now give OK, then the optimization process will go. Yeah, so now our source flow is adjusted with our GCP reading. So now we can see the error of what the error of this model. See, meter, centimeter and micrometer, it means a millimeter, sorry. 10 mm. So our GCP reading value is 0.1 centimeter. 0.1 centimeter. Okay. Now save the project. The next step called workflow tense clock. It's called tense clock. Workflow quality is medium, depth filtering is mild. Select the calculate point color. Click OK. This process will take quite time. Yeah. Now that ends cloud point process done. Go to workspans, explore this chunk. Now you can see the dense cloud offsets here. You double click on the dense cloud. Now the dense cloud point will be here. See, compared to the tie point, it means the sparse cloud. Tie point is called sparse cloud. So less points. Okay. After generating the tensor, the tensor point will the millions of points will be there. That is called the tensor. It looks like very density point. Yes.
Let's disable the flag. Yes. The next step is called the. Don't forget to save the project because this is very important process. So don't forget to save the project. Save the project, and the next step called generate the dump. After click, the dump will generate the source point from the dense cloud. Interpolation is keep as default enabled. Point pluses select all. It will be the default. You don't want to touch this. Okay, then click OK. It will be generate the dump. Dump, it won't take much time. It will, or it will take 2 to 3 minutes for based on your areas. Yes, save the project. For each step, process finish. Don't forget to save the project. Yeah. So now the dump process finished. You can see the left side panel. Dump. If you double click on the dump, you will see the right side of the dump model. Yes. Look at it's coming out well. Yes. For moving the cursor, you can see the right side bottom area. You can see the X, Y as well as Z also. See, for moving the cursor, while moving the cursor, you can see the X, Y, Z values for each moving. Yeah, nice. So we have finished till tense cloud. Finally, we are going to generate the ortho. Go to the same workflow. Build ortho mosaic. We'll click on the build ortho mosaic. For generating the ortho, we need the source dump. Based on the dump only, it will generate the ortho. So, parameters, surface is dump, blending mode is ortho. Okay, keep the pixel size the same as default. If you want the change the pixel size how much you want, you can change. But should be the same as well as the dump. Okay, click on the OK. For ortho generation, it will take time. Let's finish the process, the ortho generation.
auto generation process. So done, save the project. Right, left side reference workspace, you can see the ortho option. So double click on the ortho mosaic, you will see the ortho on the right side. Look at this, is the our ortho for area. So let's come out plan. Yes, so use this photos. Here itself we can clip the ortho and as well as stem also. The next video we'll see the how to clip the ortho and dem, and also we'll see the how to export this ortho from this Metashape software. Thanks for watching this video. If you like this video, click on the like and subscribe to the channel also, then only you will get the notification of the next video from my side. Please give the support for this video. Thank you. Thanks for watching.